Hello everyone, this is Kathy, and right now there is a unique natural phenomenon going on at my parents' house that only happens every 17 years. Now if you can hear in the background, that sound that sounds just like an alien spaceship from a 70s horror movie, that is the call of the periodical cicadas. And I am going to go see if I can capture some of these guys on video, because this is extremely rare. Last time this happened, I was 17 years old. That's the first time I can remember these guys coming out. And now I'm 34 years old, and they've appeared again. And same way, I'm gonna go show everyone these guys and document this, because it's not gonna happen again until I am 51 years old. Yeah, this five-line skink right here has been eating the cicadas, and he's just passed out on a brick wall. Yeah, say hi, little guy. Like, normally they run away. I think this one is just stuffed with cicadas. Yeah, so... yeah, like, every living creature is eating these things right now. They're like candy for all the wildlife. And they also are fertilizing the trees, because they die in really large numbers. And they're busy breeding right now, and eventually they're going to lay eggs. But anyway, like, I'm enough talking about these cicadas. I'm going to go find a whole bunch of them. Right? Hey there. You still there? Okay. So these cicadas really like hanging out in this tree next to my parents' front door for some reason. Now, what differentiates periodical cicadas from our normal annual cicadas is these guys have these yellow wings and bright red eyes. And the annual cicadas are all black. And they also just hang out in really huge numbers all over the place. See, their camouflage is not that great, so their survival strategy is just to appear in such large numbers that all the predators in the area will devour them and get stuffed and just not be able to eat anymore. And I think that these are all females, because they're not screaming. The males are the ones that make that noise. The females will just go towards them, and then, like, they're silent. Like, they don't really make any noise, but they'll find the males and they'll mate with them. And I kind of suspect that maybe these have already mated and are just waiting around to lay eggs. But I don't know, they're not very active right now. Oh, this one's walking. Let me see if I can get him to step on my finger. Come here. Come here. Sometimes they'll walk on your finger. Or it might decide to fly off. Like, they're harmless. They don't really have mouths after they hatch out of the ground. Yeah, there it goes. So, they can't really hurt you. Well, this one's out of... oh, there you go. Yeah, whoop, flew away. Yeah, and, I mean, they get all their food they need after 17 years of just hanging out underground, and they suck the sap out of tree roots. And then, as soon as they hatch out, they're just, they just don't eat anything anymore. And they stay alive for about 3 weeks. Like, so they'll only be around for 3 more weeks, and then they'll all die off, and this won't happen again for another 17 years. So these are the shells that they leave behind after they crawl out of the ground and molt into their adult form. And let me just get a, show everyone a closer look here. So, this is what their nymph stage looks like when they're underground and they're, you know, sucking the sap out of tree roots. And then they'll dig themselves out of the ground, and they all come out at the same time, and they molt and they leave these shells behind. So this little guy here was infected. There's this type of fungus that they get sometimes, and the fungus causes their butt to fall off, and it replaces it with this white thing. And so these guys, when they're like this, are sterile. And I'm not sure this one's dead or alive. I don't really want to poke it to find out. But when they get like this, they're completely sterile because their whole entire butt's been replaced by this fungus. And they'll still attempt to mate with the other cicadas, but they won't be able to reproduce. They'll just infect each other with this fungus. And this is just one of the icky things that happens to these guys. So this is my parents' lovely balcony, and as you can see, the cicadas have just randomly died all over the balcony. Like, it's kind of messy out here. I was trying to find a broom because I was thinking it'd be nice to help my parents out and sweep these guys up, but I don't know, but that's pretty much what they do. Like, you know, they come out of the ground and they make just all this noise, and then they mate, and then they lay eggs and they die. And that's pretty much their life cycle. Like, they stay underground 17 years and, and then they also get eaten in large numbers by all kinds of stuff, like, dogs, cats, squirrels. Some humans like to eat them. Like, supposedly they taste like shrimp. Like, I wonder if this little guy's alive. Hey, sir, are you still alive? Nope, he's dead. And yeah, and then once they've done what they came out to do, they just die. And I know right now, all their nice furniture is covered because after they die, they, whoops, someone just landed on me. Like, yeah, they leak, you know, guts all over the place and stain everything, so kind of have to keep the furniture covered. And then another thing is, if you live in an area where these guys are hatching out, please be sure to check your air conditioner unit and make sure they're not getting sucked up in there, because they can clog your air conditioner. Yeah, but the rest of the balcony looks really lovely. Yeah, they're just dying. Huge numbers all over the place. And they're very good fertilizer for the forest. Like, they spend 17 years sucking the nutrients out of trees, and then they die, and it all returns back where it came from. So, yeah, it's just part of what they do. Yeah, Taz decided to come out and join me. Hi, Taz. Taz, what you looking at? Hello. Like, I think he wants to hunt a few of them, huh? Don't you? Yeah? Yeah? You like hunting cicadas? Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah, like cats really enjoy eating them, along with all the other animals. Yeah, Joker, on the other hand, is just too lazy, huh, aren't you? Yeah. He's too lazy to care about cicadas. No, he just wants to stay inside and be left alone with his catnip mouse. Huh, don't ya? Or a little couch potato. Now, I've heard that there is a black rat snake that is living in the backyard right now and just feasting on all these cicadas. So I'm gonna go see if I can find him. I might not, because black rat snakes are really good at hiding. But when you do find them, they're very conspicuous and huge and scary looking, and yeah. So I'm just going to go explore around here and see if I can spot him somewhere. Well, I didn't find the black rat snake, unfortunately. Oh well, maybe it'll come out later. So just hanging out on my parents' front porch right now, and I'm actually really happy that I got to see the cicadas here, because there hasn't really been that many in my neighborhood where I live in Maryland, and I was getting a little bit disappointed. It's like, I don't know, like this is just the kind of thing where it's a blink and you miss it kind of event, and so I'm really happy they came out strong at my parents' house. My parents were not that happy about it. My stepmother has been thoroughly grossed out this whole time, but I've been enjoying them. Like bugs don't really creep me out at all. Like, I just find anything having to do with nature fascinating. So, yeah, like, I'm having a lot of fun today. Yeah, so these are, this particular group of cicadas are called Brood X or Brood 10. And they're unique to the Northern Virginia, Maryland, and Washington, D.C. area. And some people find them really scary for some reason. I just think they're really neat. I thought they were really cool when I was 17 years old. And right now, like, I think, you know, this is just a pretty interesting phenomenon. I'm probably still going to be fascinated by them next time they come out when I'm 51 years old. And anyway, same way, thanks for watching this video, and you know, this is unique to the eastern United States. Doesn't happen really anywhere else in the world that I know of, and it's just really cool. It's very rare, happens once every 17 years, and that is a very long time. A lot happens in 17 years. Like, I'm a totally different person now than I was when I was 17 years old, and you know, this kind of just brings back a lot of memories. So anyway, this little guy is just hanging out, and he seems to like me. Like, he hasn't flown off yet. So anyway, thank you, and thank you for letting me talk about this. Bye.